A friend of mine is John Lennox. He's a brilliant professor at Oxford University. He's written several books in support of God. And he has an illustration that he gives to his students. He says this: suppose you have a Ford motor car in front of you, like a Model T. He says, what accounts for the Ford motor car? I'll give you two possibilities: Henry Ford or the laws of internal combustion. And the students look at it and go, wait, Dr. Lennox, you need both. You need Henry Ford to create the car, and then you need the laws of internal combustion to allow the car to operate, to work. And he goes, aha, yes, you see it now. Why can't atheists see this point? You can study a Model T and its engine and how it works from now till doomsday. You will never disprove the existence of Henry Ford. The more you learn about the car, in fact, may cause you to go, wait a minute, this car appears to be designed. And it points back to a designer. Atheists look at the world and go, well, we don't see God out there. That would be like looking at the Model T and looking in the engine and going, I don't see Henry Ford in there. Of course, he's not part of the car. He created the car. God isn't part of the universe. He created the universe. In fact, to say that a scientist can disprove the existence of God is like saying that a mechanic can disprove the existence of Henry Ford. A mechanic can't disprove the existence of Henry Ford. The mechanic can learn everything about how the car works and operates. He will never disprove the existence of the creator. Again, he may actually show that a creator exists, because the more he studies the car, the more he realizes it had to be put together by intelligence.